Hey everybody, it's Lon.TV, and a lot of you have been writing in over the last couple of months asking me about Kodi and Plex and how I store media and play it back in my home, and I've been very reluctant to do that video because it didn't have like a cohesive strategy. I had a whole bunch of different things that I kind of cobbled together to get working, and it just involved too many different pieces of hardware, too much software, and I really just didn't have something that I could explain in a very simple and straightforward manner. But I think I'm finally to the point where I can, because I've gotten about 90% of my stuff now consolidated into a single box here for playback, and that is the Nvidia Shield TV. We've covered a lot about this in the last few months. It does a lot of things, and that's what's so cool about it, is that the last piece of the puzzle was some of the higher-end audio formats and movie frame rates that I was hoping it would support. Now it does through a new Kodi port that I'm going to talk about today. So I'm at a point now where I was setting up my new home theater nook in my workspace down here, and I said, you know what, I only need one box now to do all the things that I want to do, and that is where the Nvidia Shield comes in. Now, in full disclosure, I have purchased Nvidia Shield boxes in the past, but this one Nvidia sent to the show for us to do some things with. This is the 500 gigabyte Pro Edition, but I have been a big fan of this product long before Nvidia ever reached out to me, because it's a really an awesome Android TV box. It does everything I wanted to do now, as I mentioned, and I think you'll like what you see with this. So what I really like about the Shield and the Android TV platform in general is that you have the ability to install any kind of Android software you want on it, in addition to getting access to all the things you might want to do online. So I've got, you know, Netflix and YouTube on here, HBO Go and all the other stuff that you are usually using with a TV playback device you can get on here, with a few exceptions, of course, unfortunately, but a bulk of what I use is available, and I have access, of course, to Kodi and to Plex and to all the other services too. So while there are some cool TV boxes out there, this one really does the best. And what really attracted me to it initially was the fact that they have these really nice game controllers, and it's very powerful from a game playing standpoint. So all of my emulators that play all my retro video games from the 1990s on back all play on here. So in addition to playing back all my media, in addition to watching live TV and working as a DVR, I can play every video game I've ever played as a kid on this single box. And that's what's so cool. I've got this TV set up over there with just one box hooked up to it, because this is doing everything I want it to do. So I want to talk today about movies, because I covered all the other stuff in other videos, which I'll link down below in the video description. So what we're going to start with, though, is how I get movies off my Blu-ray discs and store them for later playback. Now, usually when I buy movies, I buy them as Blu-ray discs, and I do this for a couple of reasons. The first, of course, is that I want to own the movie, and it's something I can put on the shelf that nobody can take away from me. But the other reason is that these have a lot more data stored on them. So for example, this movie is about 35 gigabytes in size. It's very large because it stores a lot of video and a lot of audio data, and that results in better quality. So although I can buy this maybe for a little bit less on one of the streaming music or movie services, I'm going to get much better quality out of this disc because, again, it's got so much data stored on here. It also stores its audio in the lossless studio masters. So I'm getting the best possible home theater audio quality that you can get, which is going to be on this disc versus the compressed formats we'll see on the streaming video services. And the two formats that are used most typically are DTS-HD and Dolby TrueHD. And again, you can't beat the audio. It sounds great. And if you want the best possible quality, especially when you're dealing with a nice home theater receiver along with a nice 4K television, you definitely want to go with the disc versus something you might buy from one of the services. Now, to get the movie off of here, though, you do have to get some hardware, which namely would be an external or an internal Blu-ray disc reader. And I have a Blu-ray burner that I use for storing video that also conveniently reads these discs as well. And I use a piece of software called MakeMKV. And what that does is it grabs the video file off of this thing along with its audio and creates a single file called an MKV file. And that can be played back on Plex or on Kodi or on just about anything else like VLC that can play back one of those MKV files. And it's very, very convenient. So all you have to do is put the disc in, boot up MakeMKV. Usually have to go in and select a few things. And what you do is just look for the largest file that's on the disc, and that's typically your main movie file. Then you can select which audio formats you want to keep, what subtitles you want. Hit the button, and then probably about 15 or 20 minutes later, you've got a big file on your hard drive waiting for you. And what I usually do actually is take these movies and rip them right into a network attached storage device. So in my data closet over there, I have a Synology NAS drive which is basically a little server that has a bunch of hard drives on it. I've covered a lot of NAS devices here on the channel in the past, and pretty much anything's going to work. I would recommend getting a NAS device that has a DLNA media server built in, which is just a piece of software that runs on those devices that allows Kodi and other pieces of software to see it on the network without having to go through too many hoops to play it back. And once it's set up, we'll go into this in a minute, you can just load up Kodi, point it at that folder on the NAS, and then start playing back your movies on demand in their full Blu-ray quality. It's really great when it all works. And once you get everything set up, it is pretty easy to do. Now, I don't compress my movies. You might see a lot of people online talking about how they take these big Blu-ray files and make them smaller. But for me, I really want the best possible quality, both video and audio. So storage is cheap these days. I have multi-terabytes waiting for me on that Synology NAS, so I really don't have any limitations right now based on the amount of storage I can get access to for little bits of money. So I just store the full 35, 50 gigabyte file on there and play it back exactly as it was on the disc. It is really a one-to-one copy. Hollywood is not crazy about us doing this, by the way, but I think having bought many movies many times over the years, I've kind of earned my right as a consumer to decide how I wish to play back the content I pay for. I've probably bought 15 or 20 versions of Star Wars since it came out on home video in the early 80s. So I feel like we are entitled to be able to do a little bit more with our media than they would like us to do. And that's really a good reason for that too, because it adds a lot of convenience, especially when you want to have a file available on a server in your home and then play it back on any device that you are sitting in front of. So I want to now go into how I'm working with Kodi on here to play this stuff back. So the Nvidia Shield TV has had a firmware update recently that added two important things to it. One is that it added support for the lossless audio formats that I mentioned before. The other thing is that it can play movie files back now at their original frame rate. So movies are typically shot at 24 frames per second, much less than 60 frames per second that a lot of our YouTubers now are using. And if you want the way the movie is supposed to look, you need to be able to play that file back at that speed. And many televisions support that frame rate, but the device playing it back has to instruct the television to revert to that 24 frames per second mode. The Shield now can do it, but for the longest time, you wouldn't be able to get it to do it with Kodi, and the reason is that they haven't updated Kodi to support the firmware updates that NVIDIA added onto their Shield. But there is a port of Kodi that I am using that I'm going to recommend to everyone, and that is SPMC. It's available in the Google Play Store, it's available right now, and it supports both that frame rate as well as those two lossless audio formats that the real version of Kodi, for whatever reason, is not yet supporting. So this fork of it is the one you want to get. It's actually by a former member of the Kodi team. So this is somebody who worked a lot on Android versions of Kodi in the past. He's gone off and created his own fork of it. And this is what you want to get because this works and this does not at the moment. But when you boot it up, you'll notice it looks just like Kodi does. And if you're not familiar with Kodi, it's a great open source media player. Works great with so many different files, and it's really good for playing things in your home. And I have my Nvidia Shield here connected to my network. I've got a Ethernet cable plugged in. It's probably the best way to play back content with your Shield is with one of these Ethernet cables running at gigabit speeds, because you'll get the best possible connection back to your NAS device. But you could also connect an external hard drive to it if you wish. It will work over wireless AC, but if you have a lot of other people using your wireless network, you'll see some performance degradation with it. So for the best possible connection over a network, definitely go with gigabit Ethernet. And what's cool is that I'll go to add videos here. And if I go over here and browse my media locations, let me just go over to the browse button here, and I select UPnP devices, I will see that disk station here, that's my Synology NAS, show up right away. I can go over to here to video, and I have a folder of my favorite Blu-ray movies. I can just hit OK, and if I hit OK again, I now have access to those movies, and I can play them all back without having to do much of anything. I can just hit the button here, and it will start playing, and we'll get the movie starting up almost immediately. And again, it's playing over my network via that gigabit Ethernet cable from the Synology NAS in the other room. But I'm not, you know, recompressing the video or anything else, because the Shield is powerful enough to play back this movie file. Now, there are a couple of settings that you might want to do on the Shield to get everything working properly, especially, oops, I hit the wrong button there, especially if you want to use those that frame rate and those audio settings that I mentioned. So I'm just going to go ahead here and stop this movie real quick, and we're going to go over to those settings so you can see exactly how to get it working properly for your home theater setup. So we're going to back out a little bit here, go back to our main menu. You want to go over to System, and you want to go to Settings, and there are two things to look at. The first thing you want to do is go over to System, make sure you're in the Advanced Settings level here. So I'll go to Advanced, and we'll go to Audio Output, And on there, you're going to see an option for pass-through, audio pass-through. So we're going to turn that on, and we're also going to tell it that we have an AC3 capable receiver, an EAC3 capable receiver, DTS, TrueHD, and DTS-HD. And once you have all that set up, this will allow those lossless audio formats to move over to your stereo, your home theater receiver, so you can get your high-end lossless audio formats. And that is what is on SPMC, but not on the release version of Kodi at the moment. So this is one thing that this version does that the release version of Kodi doesn't. The other thing you want to do is go back out a menu and go over to the video section here. And I believe you want to look for playback. And there's an option here to playback at the frame rate of the movie file. So what you want to do is adjust the display refresh rate to always. And what this will do is look at the video file that you're playing back and then instruct the television that you have plugged into the Shield to adjust to that frame rate. So when you have a 24p video, it will play back at 24p speeds. And then you are good to go, and you have a player that is pretty much as good as your Blu-ray player is, and you'll be able to play back your Blu-ray movies over your network without having to futz around with discs anymore. You can put your disc on the shelf and leave it there and have everything stream off of your network-attached storage device. This is what I do here in the house. I've got my home theater down here and my big one upstairs. Both are working great, and I don't have to, again, move discs around the house. I can just connect everything into my box in the other room there and start playing everything back. But what about when I'm not at home and I want to play something back, or if I'm on a device that isn't powerful enough to play back that huge 35 or 50 gigabyte movie file? Well, there is a way you can do it with Plex, and that is where I bring Plex into the equation. So we're using Kodi on our network for home theater stuff, and I'm using Plex for things that just can't support the movie file or playing back when I'm not at home. So I've got Plex here running on my phone. I can just tap on one of the movies that I have here that I was watching earlier, and I can just hit play. And what it's going to do here is grab that Blu-ray file, but what it's doing in the background is actually converting this into a format that my phone can play back. And it does it pretty quickly right now because I have a laptop that I use just as like a media server in the house that's grabbing that and transcoding it. And I did a big long video on Plex and how it works, so you can see exactly what this transcoding thing is all about. But you definitely need a computer with a little bit of horsepower to be able to quickly do this transcoding in real time. And if I wasn't home, I could do just what you just saw here. I can hit the button, start playing it back, and it will stream that movie over the internet from my home to my phone. I can even download the movie ahead of time from Plex. It'll do all the transcoding to make the video smaller for me. And I can take it with me when I'm on the road as well that way. So really flexible, and that's where I really find Plex to be very valuable, because I can load up a web browser and play it back and pretty much play back my media that I have stored on that NAS anywhere in the world. But I have to do it with a computer that's a little bit faster than something that you might just have built into your network-attached storage device to begin with. So a lot of NAS devices have a server built in for Plex, but they're not fast enough to do this transcoding on the fly. You definitely probably want to have a computer sitting in between to be able to do that fast conversion there. Now, I do want to show you, though, how I have Plex configured, because I have it pointing at the NAS device so that it can grab those files whenever they're changed and keep itself updated. So let's take a look at my configuration screens. All right, so let's take a look and see how I have all this set up. What I like about Plex is that it automatically goes out to your library and finds all the cover art for all the movies that you have. So everything looks really nice. You get the official movie cover art and stuff, and they do all of that for you. Now you see here, I've got a couple different libraries set up on the side here. I'm just gonna click on the edit button for my movies folder so you can see exactly how I have it all set up. So what I've done when I created that library was I told Plex that this is a movies folder, so it knows which database to look against. And then I'm going to go over here to add folders. And you'll see here I have two folders added here. And what I did is basically just typed in the network address for those file shares on those NAS devices. So Disk Station Blu-rays is my Synology NAS, and I also have a little junk drive here on my WD MyCloud where I store some other things that I want to watch from time to time but don't want to store permanently. So it looks at both of those things and mashes them up, and I can keep adding folders also. So I can go off my local folder here or an external drive, or I can just go in here and just type in the name of the file share and do it that way. And that's how I set up those other things there. Likewise, you could map a drive and create a drive letter from your Synology or your WD MyCloud or something, but I found it's easier just to go ahead and find the exact address of the file share and just type it in here, and it will always find it and keep that directory up to date and then stream it over to your device. And what I love about Plex is that it's very flexible, and again, it's very easy to get stuff over to other devices that are not hooked up in your home network to your television. And that's why I find find both Kodi and Plex to be very complementary of each other. So a lot of people have asked me, like, oh, which one is better? And they're actually better for different things, because Kodi doesn't work all that well or at all out of the house. Plex does, and I tend to use Plex for those sorts of things. Things that maybe if I want to keep my TV shows a little bit better organized, I'll use Plex to watch them there. But for the best possible video quality with the absolute zero change from the Blu-ray movie, I always use Kodi, because that is just transferring or sending over that real file over to my Nvidia Shield that came off of that Blu-ray disc. So there's more you can do with the Shield, though, as far as having it be your go-to device. I watch live television on this using an HD home run, and I've covered that in enormous detail here on the channel, so I'm not going to repeat everything I've done with that product, but that allows me to take live TV off my cable system, or if you're using an over-the-air antenna, off of that, and it puts it right onto your box here. There's even a DVR that they're coming up with very shortly, so you can do that with your Shield. So really, this has become, for the in-home stuff, my single device that does everything. It really works tremendously well. I can play my games. I can stream games off my PC. I can stream games from their server. I can play all my emulators on it. It is really the perfect Blu-ray playback device now that SPMC is capable of those lossless audio formats, as well as that movie frame rate of 23.976. And then I use Plex for playing back things on my phone, taking movies on the go with me. Pretty much anything that I really won't do in my home network, I'll do with Plex as I head out the door. And again, I like Plex because it does organize my media a little bit better, especially with television shows that I'm recording on my DVR. It puts them into seasons and everything. So that's worked much better for me for those kinds of tasks. But I really use them both, and I use them both in different ways. So that's how I'm doing media in the house. I hope this was a helpful video. I was trying to really keep it focused in one area, because I've really covered a lot of the other things that I've talked about in greater detail. So if I missed something or you want a little bit more detail on something, do let me know in the comments below, and we'll do a follow-up video. This is Lon Seidman. Thanks for watching. This channel is brought to you by my Patreon supporters. If you want to help the channel, you can by contributing as little as $1 a month. Head over to lon.tv/Patreon to learn more. And don't forget to subscribe. Visit lon.tv/s.